the cost multi user multitasking then portable. These are the, some of the Unix operating system that is can go for Unix. It is this Linux operating system. This it is freely available. Then multi users can use multiple users and multi tasking. That is, we can execute the number of tasks or number of process n number of process. Then portable, there without with little or without modifications we can run. That is called as portable. These are the some of the advantages and disadvantages. Then what are the difference between Unix operating system and Linux? The difference based upon some characteristics. Difference. Okay. That is first of all based upon the cost. Based upon the feature. Based upon the feature. First cost. Okay. Then Unix operating system, you can get it some amount, you have to pay amount, whereas it is freely available. Then different flavors, then you can go for Solaris, IBM, okay, then in Linux, you can go for Ubuntu, Fedora, then SUSE. Okay, then there are different flavors. Okay, then this is the one difference. Then one more difference. That is file arrangement. File arrangement. It is NTFS or it is flat or it is, you can call it as, or it is in binary or XT. Okay. And for file systems in Unix, it is just a simple restructure of file list or some of the references of Linux operating system and Unix operating system. Okay, then we will go for the some more commands and and architecture of Unix operating system. In mainly in Unix operating system, it consists of four components. It is a, you can call it as hardware, architecture, kernel, shell, then users, then library, and then so many this thing components. Then here the kernel is the core part of your operating system. This then shell acts as an interface between your hardware and the external devices, whatever you are connecting. These are some of the components. And what are the remaining these things? How the files are arranged? Files are arranged in terms of a tree structure. It is in the form of a root. Okay, it is in the form of a root. Then and leaf nodes, or you can call it as children. Okay, then the root first is called as root. It is the core operating system where all the requirements to install the operating system that will be loaded or installed in the root directory. Then the next level or the next tree structure is where there are so many directories or so many first one bin, second one has been, and third one temporary, then user, okay, user, home, then home, then source, then there are a number of directories out there. Then what do you mean by this bin directory? Bin directory is one, whatever the system binary files that are will be loaded. Here binary files, here system binary files. Okay, here simple binary and system binary. Then next is temporary files. What are the temporary files that will be loaded? All will be stored in temporary files. Then next is user. The different users, suppose if you have Windows operating system, that is admin one user, then user one user, user two, there are suppose three users, then all the different users will be stored here, the different things. Then next, home, home is the current this thing, then source, that is which is the path that will be these things. These are the some of the these things, and we will see some more commands. These are the Unix operating system architecture, and we will see some more commands, that is some basic commands and some networking commands. Okay, we will see the networking commands and the basic shell, some more commands are there. First of all, some basic commands. Afterwards, we will see the network commands and so many other commands. This first basic commands, some CP. Okay, in the last class, who command, then user, then mu directory. Then now I want to copy this, so one file to another file. Okay, what is this syntax? That is, command name is CP, that is the content. CP is, this command is used to copy from one file to another file. Then the syntax, old file name to new file name, old file name to new file name. Suppose this is the general syntax of your copy command. Is suppose, then for your understanding purpose, I will give a simple example. I will create a text directory. I will name it as Raj Text. In that, I will store the names of 5 students. First, serial number, name, phone number. This one. Raj, then Ram, then Ravi, Kiran, then one more name is Satish. Then there are 4 numbers. These are the 5 contents stored. Okay. Then I want to copy the content of this file to one more new file. That is, I'll just write as whatever the name is. I'll give them as Raj Text. Then the new file name I can give as Ram or XYZ dot txt. Okay. Whatever the contents are there in this file, it will be copied. Suppose whether it has been copied or not to check, then I can give as ls. It displays 2 files, that is Raj Text and XYZ.txt. Okay. Then suppose if I don't want the, there will be a two copies of that, whereas suppose move means the contents, everything will be moved, the old copies or old the files will be removed. Okay, then this is the copy command. Then move command. Move is just change, move the contents or changing or renaming. Okay, that is called as move command. Then next, this is the simple example. Then we can give. Now presently I want to know in which directory I am working. Suppose if I want to know what is the present working directory, what is the command? The simple command is just you write type pwd. It gives the present working directory of your operating system, in which directory you are working, whether you are working in home directory or bin directory or which directory, that directory displays. It displays present working directory. Okay. This displays the present working directory. Then next, next is you can go for date. I think I have not given yesterday. The syntax is just simple. I given it displays. It displays the date, current date, current date in the format of date, month, year. Okay, it displays the current date, month and year, and followed by time. Okay, followed by time. Okay, it displays date, month and time. Next, calendar. If I want to know a particular calendar, suppose if I want to know I want to display the calendar of 2000. Okay, then I want to display the calendar of year 2000. Just you type CAL 2000. It displays the calendar of the entire year. It is Jan, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November and December. Okay, it displays the complete year of the particular year. Suppose if I want to display only particular month, what a particular month, just you type, the command is calendar. Suppose if I want to display a particular month, the particular month it can be I can say Jan, or you can take any month. Then whichever year, suppose if you are not giving any year, the current year it will be displayed. Suppose if I want to display the calendar, that is first month, okay, followed by the year, which year you want to give or which year you want to display that calendar. I want to give 2021. Means it displays the calendar of January. It displays the January. Suppose then how to know whether this calendar, now simply if you give calendar, if you type CAL, then what it displays? The calendar. Then suppose if you give the command calendar, then it displays the current month. Suppose now we are in the month of March, the month 2021, then it displays as 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, then up to 31. Then today date is 19th it will be highlighted, or it will be highlighted. Means that indicates that today date is March 19. That is, it will be highlighted, or it will be in the form of a white this thing. Then we can come to know today date is March 19, 2021. Okay, then some other commands you will see. Then we will see some more commands. Then number of process, that is how to know the number of process. The process can give as PS. It displays the process. Okay. Then next is this usage. If I want to know how much amount of memory that operating system or the C drive, how much it has occupied, D drive, E drive, then simple command is just you type du, then it displays the operating system C, D, E, how much